Welcome back, everybody. It is Angel, and this is Gaming with Angels, and I appreciate you visiting us today here on the Alierius Anthology, episode, what are we on? 66. 66. Holy Toledo. That is a lot of episodes of Alierius Anthology. That is over a year's worth of Alierius Anthology that is coming straight to you as we get through this, almost a year. Gosh, almost a year, because January is when we came out with this. Anyway, so today, Serana, Kaisa, all that good stuff. We're going to go to the Ancestral Glade today and see what kind of trouble can we get ourselves into over there at the Ancestral Glade, because why not? And Aiden is going to continue his quest to find the final word of the shout while he is in Midsummer Isle. So that's pretty much what we're going to be doing today. Thank you all for watching. Loving your comments here. And you guys are just amazing, amazing people. We've got a few of them here. You know, we've put up several copies of our mod lists, and we, you know, those of you who are asking for them, thank you so much for that, and just really appreciate all of you. let's see, Talon Shadowfang, thank you, and a little shout out to you. You're playing PC Skyrim vicariously through us. Thank you so much. We appreciate you. I hope everybody had a great Thanksgiving, if that's something that you celebrate here in the United States like we do. And I will see all of you next week. Take it easy, everyone.
Previously on the Alierius Anthology.
Hey, this is a trap. I don't like where this is going. Maybe. What the hell?
Surprised. Ha! Lord Sacris told me the location of this word. He knew you'd be looking for it. You will never get the chance to challenge Lord Sacris. Not that you would have proved a worthy match for him. You have been an irritating pest for far too long. But now it is time for you to die.
All right, Serana.
Then the rest is up to me. Are you ready to go? I'm not entirely sure what this thing is going to do when I add my blood.
There's always a good moment between when a foe sees you and when they're close enough to hit you.
Well, can I ask you something first?
Of course. What is it?
What will you do if we do find your mother?
I've been asking myself the same thing since we came back to the castle. She was so sure of what we did to my father. I couldn't help but go along with her. I never thought of the cost. But looks like we'll be dealing with the smell of rot while we're here. Lovely.
I do.
If she really is here, I wonder how my mother managed to deal with it.
I deal with it all the time.
How do you manage to deal with it, then?
For a walking corpse, you don't smell terrible.
Me? I smell like nightshade and snowberries.
Might want to have a word with your traitor who sold you this perfume.
Oh, you know what? You should be talking.
What do you mean?
I have a heightened sense of smell, you know. If you think you smell like blossoms after frolicking in a fetid cave, you are sorely mistaken. But, hey, you're actually not too bad. For a well-groomed bear.
Well, you're a snowback.
Horker face.
Milk drinker.
Protect yourself from
Right, so light all the braziers.
You know, this is what I was made for. Exploring caves, the wilderness, and killing stuff.
So you lit everything. Now what?
I think I have to touch the shrine. Motherfucker!
Holy shit!
What have you done? You almost killed him.
What the hell is your problem, old man?
Whatever caused this is not normal. Something is causing interference. This must be Zachris. Give me a moment. I will see if I can find the source of the interference.
Aiden, are you okay?
No.
This better. Whoa, look at that.
He almost killed you.
I think I found it. There's a disturbance on a small island to the northwest, off the coast.
Wait. You mean Gold Rock Island? I know the place. Valkyr and I found it and used to go there to try and find gold as children. Those were the days. It's northwest of Lundin, not far off the coast.
Yes, that is the place. If you put a stop to whatever is going on there, the Dragonborn will be free to travel to Lastimdel.
Hold on. Before we go running off, there's something I've got to ask. And I bet the Dragonborn is thinking it too. You know all the words of power. Why don't you just challenge Zachris? It would save us a lot of trouble, and you are a god, after all.
A good question, but I'm afraid it is not that simple. You see, Zachris has ties with other Daedra. If I were to directly move against him, it would give the other Daedra cause to commit war against me, and could drag other gods into it as well. Which, as I'm sure you could imagine, could prove disastrous for your world.
Huh. I guess that makes sense then. Still a bit bothersome, though. Come on, let's head to Gold Rock Island and put an end to whatever disturbance is causing the interference.
The interference is coming from the island. You'll need to get rid of it to travel to Lastimdel.
My parents always wanted me to follow in their footsteps. They were the best teachers anyone could hope for.
Right now.
I miss them.
I almost died. It hurt. A lot.
And here you are. You're everything I hoped you'd be.
I don't understand what just happened.
I don't really understand.
I don't think anybody here understands anything. Why is this such a problem? Why did you almost die? Don't do that!
Wasn't trying to.
Not the point, Aiden. You almost died. Not okay.
Well, I'll do better, I guess.
Damn well better. Now, let's head to this island and kill whatever is trying to kill you.
Yeah.
Let's get going, then.
I remember when I was on the road with my mother as a lad, someone tried to rob us. Probably thought we weren't worth much, but we sure showed him.
Staying safe, I hope.
Is that another city?
Looks like it.
Oh. Why do all of their cities look the same?
Same city planner?
Lack of imagination?
That too.
Well, it's an island, so wouldn't we have to get to the beach? Why does it keep running away?
Because it doesn't want to die.
This is the life, traveling across land such as this.
This is a surprise.
Wondering if there were people in it or if they were just being that way.
Yeah.
Ooh, chest! Mine! Aiden, I called that. That's a point.
Fine. Chest behind me, all yours.
Okay.
Just give up!
You picked a bad time to get lost, friend.
God damn you!
Nothing.
Easter days.
You're gonna share that, right? And not with the idiot elf that looks like a
pin
cushion.
They're everywhere nowadays.
Only with you, love.
These bandits would really do anything for a bit of coin. Why don't they just get it? God.
Anything. I am yours.
I
Alright, let's get out of here.
Is it getting hot, or is it just me?
You are planning on making me clam chowder with all of those clams, right?
Maybe. Bad girl you are.
Well, it's my favorite, and if you want me to do anything to help you out, I think we can make this work.
I think this is the place.
Hey, Trevek, you missed again. that where they just had the fire?
Yeah.
Oh my.
Whatever you want, handsome.
Come on! Just give up now.
I think we got it. Okay.
Head back and try this again.
I don't want to try it again.
Don't have a choice.
What Sean. If you... What if you almost die again?
I am grateful for your interest
either
in my
bedroom.
Either
I take this risk or they continue pursuing us and they kill me in my sleep.
I'm ready. More than ready.
Trying to be a martyr, but don't stop them here, they're just gonna keep coming.
I have plenty of room in my bed.
Well, just don't die. Make sure that we come back alive.
I won't. Believe me, I got plenty to live for.
Let's get going, then.
I honestly believed that this was not going to work. I would not do this. Not suicidal.
I hope so. Your sister's crazy enough to go for you.
I can feel the disturbance is gone now. The shrine should be safe now. But only you are permitted inside Lastenbell. Say your farewells, and when you are ready, lay your hands on the shrine. I shall await you there. Once you arrive, seek out the great halls. Farewell, for now.
Well, it looks like this is goodbye. For now, at least. I'm always terrible. I know I have no chance of harming Zachris, so I'll head to Alverton and await your return. Or Zachris, I suppose. I wish you luck, my friend. I regret that I won't be there to see you destroy that world, but I suspect I will know once you have. Farewell, then, and give Zachris an arrow between the eyes from me. You're still alive. I guess that means you haven't faced Zachris yet. I wish you luck.
Whatever you want, handsome.
I don't know for certain if you're gonna be able to follow me through this.
Why? What?
Maybe you can. I hope you can. But there is a chance that you won't.
No. Don't go.
Have to.
Let somebody else here on this island take care of their own stupid gods.
There isn't anyone else on the island that would even stand a chance.
Fine.
There is no one else, well, Kaisa, but she's busy fighting another world ending. Potential apocalypse. I'm glad you're here.
How can I argue with that?
I'll be here. Maybe Trebek won't be. But I'm sure I could find something to keep you busy.
Well, give him an arrow in the ass for me.
No promises it's going to be in the ass alone.
I would expect nothing.
Let's get going then. Don't be shocked. The anticipation.
Is it getting hot? Or is it just me?
I was hoping you would say that.
Watching on you.
A cup, Dragonborn. To death and glory.
Good luck, my friend. We're all counting on you.
Seek ye food or song unending? Fighting, drinking, fellowship, and boasting? Find welcome here and warm your soul.
What the hell is going on?
Welcome to the Sun Elf version of Sovngarde.
I don't understand what's going on.
Since we're in heaven.
Well, okay.
Well, at least the Sun Elf version of it.
There's a lot of butterflies here. I'm slightly confused.
I'm really glad that you've come.
Me too. Still confused.
About what?
I thought he said you only you could have.
Well, apparently you got one of the gods in your pocket as well.
I serve Nocturna.
Oh, there you go. She waggled her pretty little fingers and backdoored you in.
Well, that's weird. Do the deer not realize that they are ghosts? And that they have, like, literally nothing to fear?
Probably not.
Tell you that Kaisa went to Sovngarde?
No.
Yeah, to go to Sovngarde to fight Alduin. That's where she actually defeated him.
Huh. Okay.
Welcome, Dragonborn. This is Lastendel. A haven for all good Sun Elves. The souls of those with achievement in their previous lives are passed straight on to here. It is new that one of the living has entered here.
Need to learn the final word of power.
I know, Dragonborn. Urkelot told me. However, do not be too hasty. Time does not pass here as it does on Nern, so there is no rush. But first, you must complete our trials. We trust you, Dragonborn, but this word provides huge power, and we must ensure you are worthy of it. There are three great halls here. The Hall of Champions, the Hall of Scholars, and the Hall of Kings and Queens. You must earn the favor of each and receive a key, which will allow you to pass the gates in the basement and learn the word. Speak to Orisus Stormstrong to start the Scholar's Trial, King Thenheim to start the King's Trial, and myself to start the Champion's Trial. Good luck.
Of course, there's Tess.
What if they learn that you're not the actual Dragonborn?
I'm guessing that at least these people probably know. Like I said earlier, I am a Dragonborn, I'm just not the Dragonborn.
I'm ready. More than ready.
I do have blood of Akatosh in me, like my sister. But I'm just not the quote-unquote chosen one, if that makes any sense.
Okay. Don't like it here.
Why? How are you doing?
What do you need, love? Ask anything.
Come here.
As you wish.
Oh.
Huh?
Better.
Oh my. Thank you.
So where do we start? The elf you were just talking with, or the other two halls?
Start with the elf that she's talking to.
I'm with you.
If you happen to find one of those crossbows just lying around Fort Dawnguard, could I have it? Please?
Right now, we just need to get to Fort Dawnguard.
I think now would be a good time to talk.
All right.
I think now would be a good time to talk.
The war is almost over.
Yes, we're finally back.
Thanks, Dendar, for that.
I wasn't sure we'd make it out of there in one piece. I know this sounds weird, but I felt kind of scared for you. For both of us, the ideal masters could do anything, really. They could have trapped us there, for one. I wouldn't like to be a hostage for eternity, again.
A Gullible vampire believes in some unseen forces, huh?
Vampires is a noble cause. Sounds like a good bit of fun, too.
Maybe you're a pile of talking script jelly. The ideal masters are real. Everything I said about the soul cairn was real. There are trapped souls, cryptic, floating entities. We fought an undead dragon. What we saw basically spelled out everything I had read about that place. The Soul Cairn, Realm of Oblivion, as ruled by the Ideal Masters. And of course you didn't see them. They're called Unseen for a reason. Ugh. Wait. You're just messing with me, aren't you?
Yes. But at least you have better company than an Elder Scroll this time.
You... It's not funny. Maybe next time, I'll be the one to personally soul trap and place you in the Soul Cairn. See how you take that.
With dignity and panache, of course.
You really don't give up, do you?
Nope.
Seriously, I'm just glad it's all over. I know I can be moody sometimes, but honestly, I appreciate that you're keeping our spirits up. Thanks. Look, there is something I'd like to tell you. And I really feel like now's the time. Do you... like me? Not just as a friend, but as something else? I think you know what I mean.
I think you know how I feel.
Can't say I blame you. Then, hopefully this won't be awkward.
This is what us dwarves were always meant to do. Traverse the province and right wrongs with strength, steel, and resolve. By Ismir, I have to say, this crossbow is an amazing device. Thank you, Thane.
Wow. It's nice, actually. You are so nice and... Oh, I'm sorry. I just I wanted to...
I'm not fond of you trying to become a pirate.
How do you feel, Serana?
But at least it ended with
I feel free.
Full of them.
For once. I didn't mean to jump you like that. I just wanted to do it my way this time. To conquer my fear and do the very thing that still gives me nightmares on my terms. It had to be someone I trust. It had to be you. I used to see intimacy as a way to deceive, to take advantage, and most of all, to demonstrate power. Control, domination, degradation. It's like, all my life, I've only ever seen a facade. I just wanted to experience what it's really meant to be like for once, with you. Thank you for that.
That silver tongue of yours makes me nervous sometimes, honestly. Can't help but wonder what you'll talk about.
Let's move faster. The sun is... it's not great for my skin, if you know what I mean.
Right, made it, munchies.
Hey, Erilyn.
Hello. Serana.
My mother was a companion before she married my father. Always told me to stay away from them. Never knew why, but I listened.
Lydia, let's go see if we can get Serana a horse.
Dragonborn.
Hello.
It's an honor.
You're welcome.
I grew up in a farm in the plains, but I wanted to be like my parents and become a soldier or a mercenary. They were somewhat similar.
Hello. I need to
speak
with you.
Anything Nazim says, he just lets him into the court, which... is still a problem, if you ask.
I'm ever so grateful.
Thank you. I need a horse for my companion, please.
I
gal like you needs a war horse, I reckon.
There's actually plenty of game out on the tundra. It's a great place to hunt.
You always keep us in mind when you need a fresh horse, yeah?
There's a certain vigor in her eyes. I like her. I could either name her Phoenix because of this fire in her eyes, or Nightshade, because she also reminds me of the flowers I used to tend to in my mother's garden. I'll let you pick. I've been meaning to ask, why did you join the Dawn Guard?
Well, I've seen firsthand how much death and destruction vampires can cause. I joined the Dawn Guard to stop them.
I see. I'm truly sorry for you. If it's worth anything, I want you to know that I'll do everything I can to right the wrongs my kin have caused. All this time, I've been living idly while vampires wrought havoc across Skyrim. So many innocent people. I can understand what brought you into the fold. I'll do whatever I can to help. If it means we can stop the bloodshed, I'll stand with you. You have my word.
What is it?
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Here, I hope you like it.
Glad you're here.
Thank you. Appreciate that. I think we'll go with Nightshade.
Nightshade it is, then. Now, it's time to take you for a ride. Time to test my mettle.
Good job out there.
Whoa, interesting place.
Easy there.
I hardly see.
Watch it. Hey, where do you think you're going? Oh no.
Rana! Hold on! It's okay.
By the gods, I'm never doing something like this again.
It's okay, Serana. You just need some practice.
You don't say. Could you teach me then? Probably need your help with this one.
Sure.
Thanks, and do take it easy.
For the next couple of hours, you teach Serana how to ride a horse. It's not as frustrating as you initially expected, as she does seem to be a fast learner.
Well, now that's done. I should be able to hold my own now, at least. So the next time you decide to be on horseback, I should be able to catch up.
Perfect.
Yes? All right, then.
Right, Lydia, let's get to Dawn Guard.
See if we can't find something even more interesting.
Let's find this moth priest of ours. See if we can read this other scroll.
Thank you.
I trust your journey was successful.
By what? I've brought the Elder Scrolls, and you have a blindfold on.
I'm sorry, my friend. I can no longer be of use in this matter.
What? Why? Why? What's happened?
It's my fault. In my haste to read the first scroll, I neglected the careful preparation required. I thought I'd be able to allay the after effects, but I was wrong. Now I am paying for it.
That... The blindfold. Are you...
Blind? Yes, I'm afraid so.
Can anything be done to help you?
No. It will have to run its course. And there's always the chance I may never recover.
Then we're finished.
No, there is another way. The question is, how much are you willing to risk to find Oriole's bow?
Well, what do I need to do?
I can't guarantee you'd be free from harm. Becoming blind could be the least of your worries.
Don't worry about that. Just tell me.
Scattered across Tamriel are secluded locations known only as Ancestor Glades. There's one in Skyrim, in the Pine Forest. Performing the ritual of the Ancestor Moth within the glade should provide the answers you seek.
Explain.
It involves carefully removing the bark from a canticle tree, which will in turn attract ancestor moths to you. Once enough of the moths are following, they'll provide you with the second sight needed to decipher the scrolls.
Carefully gather the bark. How?
In keeping with tradition, you must use a specific tool in the ancestor glade, an implement known as a draw knife. Every moth priest is taught this ritual, but few ever get the chance to perform it. You should consider yourself fortunate if it works for you.
Do I need to read the scrolls in any particular order?
From what I saw in the vision, the Elder Scroll which foreshadows the defiance of the gods with the blood of mortals is the key to the prophecy. Good luck. I hope you find the answers you seek.
Thank you, I think. Serana?
What did you need?
Does it bother you that we're working against your father?
I can't say it surprises me. I kind of figured we were heading for this someday. I just didn't know when.
Will it be hard for you if we have to kill him?
If? I've been assuming that's where this is all going. I've been trying to make my peace with it. Come on, we can talk about this another time.
Can I talk to you for a bit?
All right.
What's your opinion about the Red Guards?
Well, I do admire their fondness for the sea, as pirates, sailors, or adventurers of the open waters. I used to read stories and great tales of Red Guard pirates, from the shores of Stros Mackay to the farthest reaches of the Abyssian Sea. Especially the daring adventures of Jaik Talonwood. He was a little childhood hero of mine. So what do you say? Would you like to sail the open seas in pursuit of fame and the rarest treasures?
Well, yes. Of course I would.
I was kind of just playing around, but I like your enthusiasm. Maybe we should set sail for the coasts of Hammerfell sometime. After we're done with everything here in Skyrim.
I would love that.
What did you need?
Can I...
Oh? What is it?
Do you have any funny stories to tell while you were back in the island?
Yes, I do. Don't tell anyone else, though. Sometime back when I was still... mortal, my parents ordered an entire keg of Ultimate Golden Pear wine. And yes, I know my parents were... weird. But like any other Nord royalty, they did like their wine. Anyway, what I did next was probably the most stupid and one of the best decisions I've ever made in my life. One afternoon, I snuck down into the cellar while everyone was asleep. And I thought, maybe I should have a quick swig of this. And the next thing I knew, I was laying flat on my belly with both my parents yelling at me. I supposedly finished the entire keg.
That's rather amusing.
Yes, it was. But getting hungover really isn't.
No. Agreed.
Yes? What did you need?
The war's all right. Almost over, isn't it? Thanks, Dendar, for that. It'll be good to see Skyrim come back under Imperial control.
Do you have any other funny stories?
Yes, I do. Don't tell anyone else, though. My mother had to leave the island for some urgent business one day, so I snuck into her laboratory. You know, to create some potions, test out some necromancy, fiddle around with things I really wasn't supposed to. But one thing did catch my eye. That brandy. I didn't really consider why she even had it there. I just decided to take a small sip.
Can't say I blame you.
It truly tasted like something else. So I decided to finish the entire bottle in one swig. I absolutely loved it. I was already a vampire at this point, though, so don't worry. I didn't pass out, vomit, or anything like that. But when my mother did come home, though, she was angry, most definitely. She said it costed a premium, and that it was meant to be a token gift to one of the newer members of my father's court. And as a punishment, I got janitorial duties around the castle for the better part of the month. And even as a vampire, to me, that felt like a long time.
Brandy! Okay. I smell brandy and I want to vomit, but you, whatever works for you.
Let's keep moving.
To find one of those crossbows just lying around Fort Dawnguard.
All right.
Could I have it? Please?
Why don't you, sing me something you know?
All right, here goes. A special song for you. I'm sure you know it. Our hero, claims a warrior's heart. I tell you, the Dragonborn comes with a voice-wielding power of the ancient Nord art. Believe, believe, the Dragonborn comes. It's an end to the evil of all Skyrim's foes. Beware, beware, the Dragonborn comes. For the darkness has passed and the legend yet grows. You'll know the Dragonborn's come.
By Ysmir, I have to
that
say, this crossbow is an amazing device.
I hope we reach the ancestor.
Thank you, Thane. Heavy armor woman myself, but it's nice to carry a lighter load. Archery is a good skill to take up. There's always a good moment between when a foe sees you and when they're close enough to hit you.
I think the best thing we can do is to get some food and definitely get some sleep.
What did you need?
What's on your mind?
You know, I've always been very fond of my mother's garden. Such beauty, nurtured by a master for centuries. It really showed, didn't it? Sorry. I must have gotten carried away. It's just, my childhood wasn't all bad, you know? There was some good in it, for sure.
Well, that's good.
I'm not fond of you trying to become a pirate, but at least it ended with us killing a whole grotto full of them. Sometimes, honestly. Can't help but wonder what you'll talk me into next. This is what us Nords were always meant to do. Traverse the province and right wrongs with strength, steel, and resolve.
I feel hungry.
Good morning to you as well.
Right behind you.
Thank you. Excuse me, Medea. One moment.
Thank you.
I'm hungry.
Yes. Hungry.
What now?
You're hungry, Serana? Did I hear that correctly?
I just need to feed on blood. Your dragon blood.
Come on then, drink.
Thank you.
Better.
It's so good. But what about you? Maybe you could let me help. If that's all right.
No, that's all right right now.
All right then.
Beautiful. Conventional means of travel. They're just better. Wonderful.
Carriage is the safest way to travel.
I'd like to hire a carriage, please.
Where do you want to go?
Walkree.
Climb and back, we'll be off.
Thank you. Means I don't have to walk in this bullshit, I'll be fine.
Never met one of them cats.
No dogs.
Oh well. The blacksmith is offering a reward for a dog you saw on the road. I was hoping you'd seen it. Yes, I'll stay on the lookout. Keep your nose clean while you're here, outsider.
My father told me to visit Westwall before the Thalmor invade again. time I think about what happened to Rongar's wife and daughter.
Let's go. What do I do?
There's a noble cause. Sounds like a good bit of fun, too.
I've been trying to find the right moment, but... Here, I got this for you.
Thank you.
Let's go.
Bloody weather.
You don't dabble in magic much, do you?
Let's ferret on.
Can't say anything. I barely trust any of it myself.
Yes.
Who's there? You'll survive! For a white run.
Nice shot, Lydia. Appreciate that.
You're getting to be almost as good with a sword and shield as I am. I'm a bit... You're getting to be...
Let's go.
Almost as good with a sword and shield as I am. I'm a bit worried.
Lydia, we're going to have to get you a horse. That's right.
Us Nords were always meant to do. Traverse the province and right wrongs with steel and resolve.
What's that?
Yes? Don't worry, we'll find the glade.
Let's go.
If you happen to find one of those crossbows lying around for Dongo, could I have...
Yes.
on, Serana, get on your horse, let's go.
There's always a good moment. Wonder what you'll talk me into next. The war is almost over. Thanks, Stendhal, for that. It'll be good to see Skyrim come back under Imperial control. Who's there?
Skyrim's a pretty big place, and I didn't expect it to be that big.
Hi, Ysmir. I have to say, this crossbow is an amazing device. Thank you, Thane.
Somewhere. It's a crossroad.
Did you lose your way? Shall we?
Enough! Tough day for you.
Wuss!
I was waiting. Now not your
horn. Sings you. You'll regret that. You'll survive! Let's go.
Isn't this pleasant? Nice little cave in the middle of nowhere.
Let's move.
Yes?
Can I talk to you for a minute?
All right.
What's a song you know?
The Dusk on Anvil Harbor. It's a song my mom used to sing to me back on the island. I hope you like it.
Waves touch the coast, harbored in twilight's blue. From dawn came the sunlight, with dusk it fades from our view. Calm embraces the sky, storms rage in our hearts.
White
for honor,
always be
glory,
my home.
And love.
Admit that
from Anvil we do depart. The fire lights the path, and the salt it sprays in our eyes. But warriors born of stone, they are never afraid to die. Bells on the docks, they cry out for the mortal day. And winds sing the dirge for the words we never could say. And sails fly out half-mast in the color of evening's hue. And tears break the silence for the children we almost knew. When dawn kissed the ocean, from the golden light came our birth. And when dusk falls on the harbor, to the golden shores we will return.
That was absolutely beautiful, Serana.
What's that? What's our next move?
Oh? What is it?
I've heard it's gotten a lot warmer in Falkreath since the Third Era, and no one is quite sure why.
Have you ever made up a song of your own?
I have, actually. I call it Old Stone Walls. It's relatively new. I haven't worked out the tune of it completely, but it just sort of came to me a few nights back. It's about, well, just listen. You'll see.
Old stone wall, towering over the sea, but a candle light, high up shining brightly. Tear-stained eyes, and the waves crash below. Old stone walls, deep down in the dark. Long lost hopes, and secrets sealing my heart. But then, you were there, reaching out your hand. And for just a moment, I was brought to life again. Old stone walls,
I've seen so many now. Tales and stories, and the joy of being dragged around. Your smile's so bright, I could go blind. But that's okay, if you stay by my side. Cold dripping leather, the smell of rain. You fast asleep as I study your face. Old stone walls, they don't hold me anymore. I'm happy where I am, in the grip of your arms.
Wow. Thank you, Serana.
What's our next move? Yes, let's stay and cherish this moment for a while.
What's on your mind?
I've always wondered what the Dwemer actually looked like. If one believes Nordson, they were much like elves, but with beards. But what about young dwarves? Were they indistinguishable from, say, the Ultmer then? Maybe there were other differences. Lighter skin tone, or tails? No. Why would they have tails? I don't know. Don't mind my rambling. It's just there's so many artifacts from their civilization, and yet we know so little. What did they look like? Where did they go?
That's a very...
I never knew it would be this beautiful. Someone should really make a painting for this place.
Fair point.
Hey, Erilyn.
Lydia, the next time we're over by Riften, remind me I need to stop by Waterview and pick up food.
if you happen to find one of those crossbows just lying around Fort Dawnguard, could I have it? Please?
Right, Lydia, we have to go find flying home. Flappy
but I'll
bug
admit
thing.
That this is one of the loveliest holds in Skyrim.
This.
Oh.
It's very cold. And it's very dark.
My blood boils every time I think about what happened to Rongar's wife and daughter. I'm glad we gave Mobar and Alva what they deserved.
Not very impressive, is it? If this ends up being a wasted trip, your friend Dexian and I are going to have some words when we get back.
That's fair. Still looking for flappy flying bug things.
The war is almost over, isn't it?
I mean, I think it should be me speaking with Dexia rather than you. No fans. I get it, you're not listening.
You don't dabble in magic much, do you? Can't say I blame you. I barely trust any of it myself.
I dabble in lots of things, Lydia. Just because it isn't magic and you don't see it, is it my problem? Except for that one time. I thought that was pretty magical.
Wow. Look at this place. No one's been here in centuries. I doubt there's any other place like it in Skyrim. It's beautiful.
By Ysmir, I have to say, this crossbow is an amazing device. Thank you, Thane.
No one being in here for so long, it's very well kept.
It is beautiful. I've heard it's gotten a lot warmer in Fulfreed since the Third Era, and no one is quite sure why. Getting used to heavy armor, are you? I can help you get your plates adjusted, if you'd like.
Look at that. It's a pink tree.
I'm more armor woman myself, but it's nice to carry a lighter load.
What's our next move?
This grove truly looks just as beautiful as you are.
I may be out of the loop on the whole romance thing, but that pickup line is just bad. Abysmally bad.
I would never. I'm not some milk drinker.
Good, I'm glad that's sorted. kind of got worried for you a bit there. Anyway, I'm glad you're here with me. It really is picturesque, and I couldn't have gone this far without you.
Same here.
You know, this is going to sound odd. I mean, with everything that's going on. The prophecy, the scrolls, the certain death looming over us all the time. But this place is so beautiful. It's kind of like I used to imagine, you know. Make love to the one person in my life in the most beautiful grove in all of Tamriel. My, maiden dreams. They're just some silly fantasies I had back when I... before... well, what I got was the exact opposite of everything I had imagined. I guess it's ironic, now that, thanks to my father, I'm here. With you. Do you think I'm beautiful? Alluring, even. Ravishing? Do you want me? Why don't we make Dibella blush? Right here, right now, like there's no tomorrow.
What? Are you sure? Are you alright?
Oh. I'm really sorry. You're not really interested in me, are you? This... I don't know what came over me.
It's not that. You are beautiful and alluring and all of those things.
But...
you're just not yourself right now.
What do you mean?
You're attractive, and I like you a lot. It's just...
But then why...
I want you to feel safe. Be sure that's really what you want.
I don't know what to...
We are in danger. All of Tamriel is. So it may feel like it's now or never. But I'm not going anywhere. Once this is all over, we'll come back here and make love in the most beautiful grove of all of Tamriel. But I want it to be your free choice.
And we'll make Dibella jealous, right?
Promise. It's beautiful here. Just as beautiful as you are.
You're sweet to say that. You always say what you think, don't you?
I do when I mean it, yes.
Yes, I know you do. I can see it in your eyes. Thank you.
Now, the Elder Scrolls, they're dangerous. So give me a moment, please.
I understand. Take your time. I never trusted those damn scrolls. Just look at Dexian. Anyway, whatever happens, being out here with you makes everything else worth it.
Would you still say that if I went blind like Dexian?
Of course. I care about you. A lot. You deserve to be happy. I promise you, I'd never do anything that could hurt you.
Now, who's the sweet one?
The world is alive after all these years. It's exactly what I'd imagined when I was a girl. In my books, anyway.
Bit of a romantic, were you?
I was. Obviously, that didn't appeal to my mother.
Do you think... you still think we can help her?
I don't know. Honestly, it took me up until now to figure out that my mother was really just as bad as my father.
She did seem willing to try.
I can't say it surprises me, but I figured it would be more of an issue for you.
It's not easy.
I guess it never is with families, is it?
Are you saying we're family now, you and I?
Yes. This is the part where we usually get closer. Bonding, if you know what I mean.
Serana admitted to herself, at last, that love had found her. Kind of love that she, a daughter of Cold Harbor, never dared to hope for. Her heart grew under the warming rays of this love, and the world before her eyes changed and came alive.
You keep surprising me.
You seem to really enjoy our intimacy.
I did. I never knew it would be this beautiful.
I'm glad. You deserve to be happy.
Thanks. I care about you. A lot. Like the best of friends.
What's next for us?
This is the part where we usually get closer. Bonding, if you know what I mean.
Each time you get hungry, we will practice a Tibetan art together.
As you wish. I'm willing to do it for us. But it has to just be me and you.
Just us? That's all I want.
Me too.
Serana fed upon the blood of her lover, that divine gift of the god Akatosh, which filled her lover's veins. Then she kissed her lover with all the burning passion that was filling her once dead heart.
Still here. Thane.
If you won't mind, I'd like us to relax here for a bit.
We can do that.
Stone walls towering over the sea. But a candlelight high up shining brightly. All alone, sitting in the bay window, tear-stained eyes, and the waves crash below. Old stone walls, deep down in the dark. Long lost hope and secret sealing my heart. But then you were there, reaching out your hand, and for just a moment I was brought to life again. Old stone walls, I've seen so many now. Tales and stories, and the joy of being dragged around. Your smile so bright, I could go blind. That's okay, if you stay by my side. Cold dripping leather, smell of rain. You fast asleep. As I study your face, old stone wall, they don't hold me anymore. I'm happy where I am, in the grip of your arms.
Thank you, Serana.
I think we're good now. Let's move.
Well, we got the knife. Now all we need to do is track down one of those canticle trees.
I believe this tree here is what we need.
Do you need something?
What do I do with this knife?
Well, if I were a betting woman, I'd say it's a scraper of some sort. Mother had something similar back home when she was tending the courtyard gardens to scrape moss and fungus off the trees. That one's far nicer, though. Almost ceremonial.
Have you ever seen anything like this?
It's not like anything else in Skyrim, I can tell you that much. From now or before. There's probably groves like this all over Tamriel. Most people just don't even know what to look for.
Interesting.
Just you and me against the world now. Not that I'm complaining.
And the deer.
Still
here. Don't forget the deer. Can't forget the deer.
Hope the moths like that bark as much as Dexian said they would.
Come on.
Nothing else, then?
I have to attract moths. Flappy flying thingies.
Look at them. They've definitely taken a liking to you. And unless I'm seeing things, you're starting to glimmer.
Glimmer? Lydia, did I get bitten by something that I don't know about?
Looks like we're on the right track.
She says I'm glimmering. Oh, I better not have been poisoned. Flappy flying fluttery thingies. Hello. Where are you? Are there some more? One of them tried to fly in my mouth.
You must think my life has been so strange.
Little, but I mean... Damn! These stupid moths. Why do they keep trying to fly in my mouth?
They seem quite taken to you now that you're carrying some tree bark. I guess we should have seen this coming. Moth priest, moths. They're apparently related in some way.
Do you think?
Couldn't hurt to gather more, I suppose.
How many?
Well, unless my vision's playing tricks, there seems to be some sort of magical effect around you. Seems like we're on the right track. Otherwise, I don't have the faintest idea.
Perfect. Stupid, flappy, fluttery things in my mouth. Stop! Stop that! No, do not fly up there. You don't know what that is. Whoop! There's another one. Stop! No. That's mine. They're in my hair. They're in my hair. Lydia, get it out of my hair. Oh, bugs. The things you do for that L word thing. You know, when I get back to Solitude and I talk to Tullius, he better be damn well fucking pleased. I'm going to...
Mm-hmm.
I think I got them all!
I think that might have been what we were waiting for. Let's head back up there and see if we can read the scrolls.
Yes? What did you need?
Now what?
The effect around you looks an awful lot like that huge column of light shining on the dais. Let's check that out.
Right.
Ready when you are.
Dude, I got one in my armpit. Ew. Stay out of my face! Ugh! Can't see shit. Oh, and I report this. Lydia, let's make a bargain. You don't tell Aiden about moths flying up in places where they shouldn't be, and I won't tell Aiden you have a crush on him. I'm serious. You say one word, and you're done. The last thing I need is him thinking that I have moths at places where there shouldn't be because he hasn't been touched in forever. Light, bright, flappy things. Let's do this.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shit!
Are you okay? Almost thought I lost you there. You went as white as the snow.
That felt strange.
I could see it in your eyes. You looked 1,000 leagues away. What about Ariel's bow? Do you know where we can find it?
It's in a place called Dogfall Cave.
Then, it's almost over. We can finally put an end to this ridiculous prophecy. Where is this Darkfall Cave?
The scrolls they gave me, it's a location. I still have a moth wing in my mouth.
Then let's get going. I want to get there before my father has a chance to track us down.
Okay.
We can finally put an end to this ridiculous prophecy.
Thank you.
Lydia, don't look now, but I think we have company. I'm just glad. Nope, still got one. Ah! No! That's a gargoyle! That's a gargoyle!
It's time.
Shoot it! Shoot it! Lydia, shoot it with something! No! Gargoyle! Stay down! Stay dead! Have the decency to stay dead! But... Die! Damn it! Stop hitting me, old man! I'm busy!
Stop whatever. Come at me.
Look! I don't have time for you! I'm still digging morph wings out of places I shouldn't be! You as well, you dumb, stupid night stalker!
You can't stop us!
Oh, bullshit! Watch this, motherfucker! Do I get to summon the moths? Are there any more? Serana, I think they found us. Lydia, check to see if we've been bitten. Stupid gargoyle. You know what I should do? I should just kick it right in its stupid ugly head.
Right behind you.
What's our next move?
What do you know about Oriole's bow?
Not much. If you read any history, it shows up from time to time, but it's a hard thing to track. As far as I know, though, it's never been held by a vampire. That would be a new one.
What does it have to do with the sun?
Auriel is one of the elven gods. He's with the rest of them in Alierius. The way I've heard it, the sun represents the connection from our world to theirs. Supposedly, the bow draws its energy from the sun itself, which is why it shows up in that prophecy.
What exactly does it do?
That part, I don't know. Once we have it, hopefully, it'll be obvious. Lead on.
Dumb gargoyle. Stupid mods. Bloody vampires. Not Serana. The other ones. Oh, good, she didn't hear me. Lydia, we'll head back to Elysium, pick up storage, the food, and maybe some ale and
right
wine, and sleep. Definitely, let's sleep.
An interesting place.
I hardly see any Nords here. Right behind you.
Let's ferret on. It's nice.
Never saw anything like this back on the island. I'm so glad I left that place.
That silver tongue of yours makes me nervous sometimes, honestly. Can't help but wonder what you'll talk me into next.
I mean, you're not wrong.
Now, tell me that I hid my regular serving here some bucket there. Go there, that can go there. Close enough.
Archery is a good skill to take up. There's always a good moment foe sees you, and when they're close enough.
What did you need?
Harkon really isn't letting up. I wasn't expecting an ambush back at the gate.
Yeah, I almost thought I lost you for a bit there.
Me too.
I definitely wasn't expecting a fight. And not after, well, you know what I'm talking about.
To you being all sweet and stuff. Yeah.
If this ends up being a wasted trip...
So, how are you feeling about all this? The road, the prophecy, the fact that I was eating moths?
Confident.
Perfect.
I've never felt so determined in my life.
I'm glad.
And if we can survive the Soul Cairn, then confident, this should be a walk in the park.
There's actually plenty
unless
of game out on the tundra.
How far we've come it's was all because of me, while you just followed. I mean, I am a royal vampire, charmer, alchemist, and mage. Well, you are...
I'm a pathetic milk drinker who just so happened to kill an undead dragon.
Your
getting to be.
Though, you didn't kill it, technically. I mean, isn't that guy. Dunavir, was it? Your soulmate now?
Really? My soulmate? He just. Shit. You're not wrong. He just earned my respect as a fellow Boreal, that's all.
Getting used
best
to
friends.
Armor, are you?
That's the real reason you call him to Skyrim. If you'd like. People in Whiterun must have thought it was Thunder, but it was just the two of you gossiping. Anyway, enough of that. We got a bow to find. But first. Thanks for helping me keep our spirits up. In dark times like these, a good sense of humor makes all the difference. You are making a difference. For me.
Yes? What did you need? Something?
I never get tired of the sight of the sun rising behind Dragon's Reach.
You want to have a drink?
Sure thing. Do you want to have it standing here, or do you want to find a seat first?
Let's have it standing.
All right. Now, onto the drinks. My mother was a do you want to have mead, wine, or just plain
always
milk?
Told me to stay away from them. Never knew why, but I listened.
Really? Milk? Really? Bring on the mead.
Like a true Nord. Good pick. I don't think you have that on you, though. Here, I'll help you out.
My blood boils.
Cheers.
Every time I think about what happened wrong.
Likewise.
Any thoughts of what's been going on lately?
Remember the Civil War? The one that you got yourself involved in? Waking up to this whole mess was truly something I did not expect. I expected a change in who was the High King, but I didn't know that things. They were more complicated. Cyrodiil being the seat of an empire, for one. And besides this whole civil contention for Skyrim's land, we have Altmer nationalists eyeing to conquer it as well.
So, has anything been on your mind lately?
If you know, I was thinking it was solitude that got me into conjuration, really. A skeleton doesn't sound like great company, but, well, I felt very lonely. But hey, not anymore, thanks to you. So, what do you want to talk about now?
But at least it ended with us killing a whole grotto full of them. Hunting vampires is a noble cause. Sounds like a good bit of fun, too.
Nope. What are your thoughts on dungeon delving?
Don't you ever get tired from these kinds of adventures?
Not really.
Venturing into a decrepit, dusty old crypt, skulking with draugr and traps?
No, I really don't.
This is what
and why is that?
Always meant to do. Traverse the province and right wrongs with strength.
I just love it. I'd love doing it.
Me too. Maybe I'm just tired of this whole dungeon thing.
Thanks, Serana. That was a good talk.
It's nice spending time like this, just having drinks together.
You if you stay away from them, But they usually have a lot of gold stashed in their camps.
Which is very,
know what they do
very nice.
Next time on the Alierius Anthology.
Die, but we are going to talk about
now
this
how
betting
about
against
that
me
for
thing,
show.
Especially when it involves my death.
But don't leave yet. We're just getting started.
Fine?
Round one is over. But will the Dragonborn continue to survive?
We won't talk about this later. Don't worry about it.
Yes, we will.
Oh, no, we won't.
And now, the next round is about to begin.
Remember that next time.
I hope we don't have any followers of Hursine in the audience, because things are about to get wild as the Dragonborn faces off against the pack. Werewolves!
So you've been to.
Werewolves!
So you've been to a plane.
Good morning, Serana.
Getting used to heavy armor, are you? I can help you get your plates adjusted, if you'd like.
If this ends up being a wasted trip...
Well, it's time to wake up.
I need you to kill Archcurate Vertha, my brother.
Why?
The kinship between us is gone. I don't understand what he's become, but he's no longer the brother I once knew. It was the betrayed. They did something to him. I just don't know why Auriel would allow this to happen.